Thank you so much. Namaskar. It's a great honor to be here and share whatever little I know in my journey regarding omni products, opportunities, challenges, and way forward. I have about 15 years of experience in the field of organic food, and I have a team which has experience of over 100 years in this. Why we need organic? That's very, very, very important. As you know, I'm coming from Delhi. The newspapers are flooded with pollution, major issues. And if I'm not wrong, you will find one or two people in your family itself suffering from some of the major diseases like cancer. The reason is, one and only one, as proven by the research, the quality of food laced with insecticides, pesticides we eat in our daily life. I was talking about the challenges. The first challenge is, no one is ready to do the farming now in this country, in fact across the world. The reason is, you are mostly dependent on the rain god. Your cost of purchase is decided by the government. So I am doing all the hard work. Finally, gehun mein 15 ya 16 rupaye kilo bech raha. I am sure none of us would be in the business where government or some other person is deciding the cost of the my sales. For example, my MRP, if from tomorrow government starts deciding, I'm sure I'll close the business today. The reason is, I know my input cost. I know the issues, I know the pain, I know the problem. So I also should be able to decide my profit source. Because profit is not a bad word. Profit is critical to survive, critical to sustain. So drought-prone areas, lot of unemployment, youth are running towards cities. The big cities are busting the chains. Infrastructure is a major problem. Youth are shunning away from the farming, as I said, and of course, chemicals-based food we are eating. The challenge number two is availability of clean food, good food at affordable prices. Health issues and health crisis, and so on and so forth. The most important and the difficult of all is the lack of trust customers have on the organic food products available in the country. Thousands of companies are there in our country, but customers are still doubting whether the product is authentic, organic, because everyone is certifying it, everyone is having the logos, but customers are still in doubt. And of course, there is a higher cost of production, for which there are many reasons associated with it. Opportunities. There are huge, many opportunities in fact. India has a legacy of over 5,000 years. In this country, a balanced or a clean food is the best medicine. In our country, it is said, food is your best medicine. The thali we eat, it has got everything in it. Some achar, some papad, some dal, some rice. Everything makes a balanced, wholesome meal. But we have moved out of it. Every region has a unique product, great for health. And in fact, the research says more people die by consuming the Western medicine. I'm not saying we are against Western medicine. Yes, in case of emergencies, in case of issues which are not controllable by the normal Ayurveda practices, certainly one has to go for the allopathy. But whatever little we understand from the India's legacy, 95 or 98% of the issues can be controlled just by eating healthy, clean food. Awareness about Ayurveda and organic products is increasing not only in India, but across the world. And of course, huge land banks are available. Many hundred different varieties of medicinal herbs are available. Different millets, different grains, lentils, everything is available in this great country. This country has all kind of weather, all kind of land banks available. The key is, how do we utilize this opportunity? Way forward. I'm not going to talk just theoretical. I'm just going to share with you practically what we have done as far as organic wellness is concerned, remote villages, the remotest area of our country, so called backward area in Bundelkhand, Tikamgarh district or Diwali district now, is village Bombay. We have set up a plant over there, a modern plant. We have given employment to the complete local youth. We are working with the marginalized farmers having a land holding of 1 to 3 acres. We are focusing on innovative crops where we can really give good returns to the farmers like moringa, quinoa. Quinoa is a product from Peru, but we have been able to grow in our country. In turn, what we have been able to do is create trust for the customer. A customer is able to relate with organic wellness that here is a company which is in a remote village, working with directly with the farmers, and in turn we are also able to price our product substantially lower, good for the masses. And of course, this is a simple slide which shows how organic wellness is impacting the business model in the country. On the one side is the issues what I discussed. We have a factory in the remote village. You can see the beautiful range of products over there. Plant you can see over here, and of course gathering of our farmers below a burger tree or a banyan tree which is over half a year old. A location in India where it is very, very difficult to see even a normal human being, and we started a plant over there. Power is a major issue. We set up a plant where we have direct connection from the grid. We don't run power generators. You can see the gallery of the plant, a modern plant run by the local village youth. We don't have anyone outside the village operating in the plant. We have all the possible certifications. On the left hand side, what you see is the picture which was there before we entered this village. And now the same children, they are running these automatic machines with highest efficiency possible. We have got visitors coming from across the world visiting the plant. We are supporting the youth, supporting the children by education. Lifelong scholarships being given to the local youth, the local children over there, so that they can really progress in their life. This is the range of product we have. We have over 170 products. We have range of about 19 tulsi teas or infusions or different flavors with us. We have about 28 food supplements good for health. We have complete range of lentils, spices and superfoods like quinoa. We are exporting to over 28 countries from this small village Bombay. The plant what you see makes from chocolates to teas, to food supplements, then you name it, about 170 products are being processed back from this plant by the local youth. This is our boardroom. Even at a 48 to 50 degrees temperature, we have never felt the heat. It's one of the amazing places to feel fit and fresh. Regular direct meetings with the farmers, their families. Plastic-free villages, we give our jute bags so that villagers are part of the system. Timely support to the farmers and their families. Supporting leprosy home in and around the village. Lot of press coverage we get at no cost. We as a business don't invest any money in getting the press coverage, but press loves us. We get a lot of coverage in Times of India, Hindu, and some of the major newspapers of our country just because of the work and the initiative what we have taken as organic wellness. Delighted customers from across the world, from Sadhu Baba to people from France and of course different parts of the world. Trade loves our product. We are present in small cities, medium towns, big cities, metros across India too. And the best part is to see a samosa wala in a small village called Barua Sagar selling the range of products. And of course, we are present in Bangalore, Canada, different parts of the world. We are trying to connect with students at school level, like this is the interaction with the students in Sindhya School, Gwalior. Trying to catch them young, trying to connect with them so that they can start learning about the basics, learning about the importance of organic in their life, and hopefully take it forward. Lot of awards because of the initiative what we have taken. I just run through them. We have been very, very lucky to have these recognitions from the eminent personalities in the country. And above all, our case study has been published in ISB that we taught in UK and Canadian institutes. To know more